Obviously, today was an extremely high-level basketball game. It felt like a MAC tournament championship-style atmosphere, intensity level, playmaking by both teams. Both teams, I think, have good players. And boy, did they make a lot of plays. Their team did. Our team did. The only thing I said after the game to my athletic director and on the radio after the game was it was just a shame we're in a COVID environment and we didn't have fans in here today to enjoy a game like that because it was high level. Anybody that watched that game, you know, that was a high level college basketball game. So, you know, got a lot of respect for Toledo, how good they are, how well coached they are, their players, they have really good players. They're so good on offense, execute so well, and you know, obviously we made a play or two. We were fortunate to win, but our guys made some big plays. We recruited Meshi to make shots. I believe he's capable of making shots. When I recruited him at Illinois, we recruited him to make shots. Obviously, he ended up going to Rutgers and then on to Iowa when the coaching change took place. I've always respected him as a shot maker. He's made them in practice last year, this year. He has great touch, a beautiful stroke. He had not made them at an efficient level thus far through the seven games coming into this one. And he and I even met this week, and I felt like he was letting it get to inside his head a little bit and affecting some other areas of the game. As you saw today, he drove it a few times and made some plays, got some rebounds and busted out dribble. He can play defense with his positional size and length. And I said, Meshi, you know, you can do more things than just make shots. And you never know if you get caught up in those things and free your mind up, the shot making will come. Zarius was the same way last year after sitting out a full year and not playing for basically a year and a half on the transfer from Dayton. You know, I think Brian and Meshi, as we continue to play more games, get more practices, more games under their belt, they're going to, I really believe in those guys. I think they can take and make open shots. So, you know, I'm so glad it went in for him. I'm sure it's a real confidence booster. He's been in here constantly since we got back on July 30th, getting extra work in. And so I'm glad that he's benefited from that and obviously happy that it went in. There's some places that don't draw, and we draw, and our fans love basketball in Akron. And when we play MAC games in particular, and we're playing a Saturday game against the league leader. Of course, you were probably here last year, George, when it was near a sellout. When we played them last year in another high-level game that was 99-89. Whether it was Ohio here last year to finish to win the MAC championship at that point, or the last game against Kent when we honored Romeo and it was sold out. Like, we draw, so we miss our fans. We do. And obviously, we've played some good basketball at times this year. At other times, we've been so-so. We're trying to get that consistency. But today just happened to be one of those games where I really did think of the fans in Zips Nation afterwards, thinking, man, would they have enjoyed that one. You know, anybody that would have been in our building today, I mean, they would have left, you know, they would have got their money's worth. You know, that was a high-level, entertaining college basketball game.